First of all, we have to create entity class, right? First of all, we have to create this entity class. This project is storing data, creating entity and storing data in one middleware class like database class and store data through the form. Like we can create one property, it is for demo purpose, right? Walk and double tap, right? Now you can create entity class, right? You just put over here p underscore price, right? And here is the price, right? This private data is stored in a memory, but this price data is not stored in a memory, but it can display on a coding side, right? This one is the get method and this one is the set method. We can create getter and setter method. When we create only a get method, we can say it is a read only memory. When we are creating set method only, we can say it is a read only memory. Both we are creating together, it means it is a getter and setter method, right? It is a read and write method, property, read and write property. So this one is the property class. So now we can check inside the this one, right? So here we can use p1.pid, right? That way we can access the property, right? So now we can create one more class. Its name is a product db class. Product db can use for save the data object and display the data object. So we have to create one method. Its name is the save product db. Inside the save product db, we can pass a product and product entity class. So first of all, we need to create private object prod as product entity. It is a array based object, object of array, right? Now this one is a one primitive variable. Its name is a count. If first of all, we can assign with zero. Here we can use whatever object we can assign through this product entity. So it goes in the product in the bracket cnt. Cnt means it is the index, right? So whatever index, product zero means first subscription variable of product object. Product object is a type of product entity class. So
here, sir, routine acronym.
So now one more method, its name is display method, product display method. Product display method return type is product entity. So we have to return same object as a product, return product. So we can create a product object as a globally. So we can use product is in save function or inside a display product data function. So this is the function and this is the procedure. It is not a function, right? But it is a function. It is a type of function because here is the keyword function, right? Now first we create a entity class, then we can create a db class. Its name is the product db. Now we can use inside the designing class, right? We can create designing
चले मंडल है हम आने की जरूरत बात और बेस्ट पर
create a one text box right? For PID, P name, P quantity, product DB. So list box one, item dot add, PID, P name, P quantity, right? This is the, when we add the record, and it's a record saved in a object. Now we can display the record in combo box. Use this coding. Deem product list as a product entity equal to product DB dot display product data. This method is a globally we have to we have to create that method globally, right? So this is the code for adding data in an object. Here is the display data, right? This is the for each loop product in product list. This is the product list as a entity equal to product DB dot display product, right? And suppose data is having some value, it means product DB is not not nothing, then we can populate the data in combo box. So first we enter one, like a test, like 20, and we can add the value in here. Now here there is no record, but when we click on a display product, we can show the data in drop down also. Now again two, paste one, and 300. Now again add entity, and there is no record, but when we click on if we want to debugging this method, how to pass this record, how to pass this inside the function. So we can this is the breakpoint we can check right now when we click on a display, right? So our value is goes here, right? This method is right. First we create a product or DB, right? Here is the product inside the product DB. This is the display product. Now returning objects. So click, whenever you click over here, you can show there is a two object inside the inside this product object. First is and second to paste one. This is the second object. This is the first object. You can clearly see the this array, an array having a first and two contain two value, but the rest of value are remain. So we can add 10 record. We don't enter more than 10 record. So this is the that way we can check the through the debugging, we can check how to code is running. So now we can click on this display, right? So thank you for watching this video. Okay, now I stop.